Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. Rep. Shot by crazed gunman issues perfect response to FL shooting. During an appearance Thursday evening on Fox News, House Majority Whip Steve Scalise scolded Democrats and their mainstream media allies for having responded to the mass shooting in Florida earlier this week by once again calling for unnecessary and potentially harmful gun control laws. Besides being sleazy, since no tragedy should ever be politicized, their rhetoric was also wrong, Scalise told Fox News host Laura Ingraham. They don't know the fact of that particular event. And again, look at their bills, read their bills. They have nothing to do with these kind of shootings, he said, referencing not only the shooting this week but those in the recent past as well. Take Nicolas Cruz, the troubled 19-year-old suspected of killing 17 during a mass shooting Wednesday at the Stoneman Douglas High School in Florida. Conservative Tribune reported that he had no criminal history and was therefore able to pass a background check and obtain the guns he used. What law could have possibly stopped him? Why you go find your law that was going to prevent this or the next shooting, Scalise, who himself became the victim of gun violence when a deranged liberal opened fire during a congressional baseball practice session last summer, continued in his frustrated tirade Thursday. And first of all, whatever criminal did these actions violated a whole host of other laws too. So, if you think there's some magic unicorn law that's going to stop it from happening, just keep in mind that he violated probably dozens of laws already, including murdering people. It's against the law. So, this idea that one magic law is going to stop the next one from happening, it's not. In other words, criminals will always break the law because breaking the law is what makes them criminals in the first place. Thus, restrictive gun regulations wouldn't actually affect criminals like Cruz, instead they'd affect those law-abiding Americans who use guns to stop crimes and defend their own families. Scalise also addressed the left's despicable attacks on thoughts and prayers, saying, "What I first think we need to do is pray for the people that died, the families too, and all of these kids, Laura. There were a lot of kids that witnessed this that are going to have this with them the rest of their lives. The prayers helped me tremendously," he added, alluding to what he experienced after almost being killed last summer. Given that Scalise was himself a victim of gun violence, I feel his perspective should count for more than that of, say, former President Barack Obama, who felt compelled to file his own plea for more gun control in a tweet this week. But apparently, the 1+ million who liked this tweet disagree. And frankly, that's a shame.
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.